Well, on to a Vyond exclusive from New York, and India First is not a threat to any other country, and India is entitled to priorities it needs. That's the consensus view of experts. Speaking to Vyond's Palki Sharma Upadhyay, the head of BJP's foreign cell Vijay Chauthaiwale, and the founder of the US-India Political Committee Sanjay Puri, insisted that India under Prime Minister Modi has moved away from non-alignment towards strategic autonomy. Their view was endorsed by Dr. Philip Oldenburg, professor at the Columbia University as well. The experts also discussed the strains in Indo-Pakistan ties and the spectacle that the Howdy Modi event was. Listen in to this excerpt.
How do you define the foreign policy of the Modi government?
Like any other country, Mr. Modi is saying that India first, and there is nothing wrong in it. India first is not at the cost of any other country, may it be relationship, may it be trade, may it be security, as long as India's interests are served in partnership with other countries. And therefore, we would like to have enhanced trade with our friendly countries. We would like to have very good relations with our friendly countries. And at the same time, those who are hurting our interests, we will be very strong on them. So that is a nutshell of Prime Minister Modi's foreign policy.
Mr. Puri, Prime Minister Modi's personal profile as a global leader has grown in the past few years. What kind of a bearing do you believe it has had on India's foreign policy and India's approach?
You know, when I look back at U.S.-India relations, the personal chemistry of the individual makes a huge, huge difference. When you look at the U.S.-India nuclear deal, there was a chemistry between President Bush and Prime Minister Modi. And what Prime Minister Modi has done, if you notice even last night, there is that personal chemistry that he has built. And it's not just with the United States. You look at Japan, you look at Germany, and many other strategic countries. And I give him 200% credit for doing that, because ultimately, like in business or anything else, it's all about personal relationships. So I think that's what he has done, and he's built India's brand outside. And historically, he's always been very close to the diaspora. Even when he was Chief Minister of Gujarat, if you ever attended the diaspora summit, his was the most popular event within that. There would be 20 chief ministers, but his would be the most, because he knew that everybody here were individual ambassadors for India. They were brand India in many ways. So he understands that, and I think better than any other leader that I've seen, at least.